Hello and welcome to the Birst how-to series. In this video, I will go through the Birst Cloud Agent installation. The Infor Birst Cloud Agent is a Java application that enables you to make connections to sources behind your organization's firewall for extracting data to Birst or for live access. You can connect to files or databases. The agent uses a JDBC connection. Birst supplies a Microsoft SQL Server JDBC driver with the product, but if you are using another type of data source, you need to download and install the appropriate JDBC driver for your data source. The agent works on Windows, Mac, Unix, and Linux. It requires Java 8 JDK or JRE, and it needs access to the data sources and the internet. So let's go through the installation. The Birst Cloud Agent installation file can be found through the connection properties. So we start with either an enterprise or professional space. Once the space has been created, we go to Modeler and Connect page and have two options, SQL databases or files. I will be using the SQL databases option this time. Once in properties, the Select Agent button is in the middle of the page. From there, we get to the list of agents available and download local agent option on the bottom of the page. Once the file has been downloaded, we go to the download folder for the installation. The actual installation is really, really simple. All you need to do is right-click the file and choose extract all. I like to extract the agent to my C root, but you can choose the location of your agent files freely. I also put in an identifier at the end of the folder name so that I know what environment I am connecting to with this agent. So that's all that is required for the installation. To get the agent running, we need a couple more steps. Now, first of all, the agent can run in a batch mode or as a service. The instructions for making it a service you can find in the README file in the agent installation folder. There are properties you can change, and those are inside the agent.properties file. And for that, the information you can find in the help section of the product. Now the agent is under the bin folder. And if you've done this before, you can simply double click the agent file to start it running. Sometimes you need to right click and run as an administrator. This is a first time installation, so I haven't used this agent before. So I'm going to go to command prompt to start the agent. The reason for that is that with the command prompt, I actually get to see what's going on with the agent as it's starting up. So I'll go to start and I'll start typing command. So we get the command prompt available. I'll start the application. I'll first go down to the C root and from there to the installation folder we just created. Once we're there, I'll just start the agent. While the agent is starting up, a quick note on Java. Java not being installed, being the wrong version, or Java Home not having been set are the main reasons for errors when trying to start up the agent. So look for those if you come across problems here. I didn't. My agent is running, so a couple of things on this page. First of all is the agent name. The name comes by default from the name of the machine where the agent is installed. It can be changed on the portal if required. The second thing is, what are we looking for when the agent is up and running? The text is polling Birst for tasks. So that tells us that this agent is active. It's asking for queries to run, data to provide. One last thing before we can start importing data. We'll go back to the portal. And when we have installed a new agent, let's refresh the list. And then choose active agents only so that we can see the actual active agents in this environment. Now my agent is on the top, so I'm going to choose that. And then we'll go back and can start filling out the rest of the connection information. That's how easy it was installing the Birst Cloud Agent. Thank you for watching.